thank you for joining me with ArtSphere today. We are going to be starting our new curriculum on numbers, math, and counting, and things like that. So I hope you guys can join me for the rest of this semester. And we are going to be starting out learning about the number zero. So what you're gonna need for this, we're not gonna do a huge art project, but we are gonna learn about how to write it, how to look for it, and how to spell it out. So you're just gonna need a piece of paper. You can get a colorful piece, you can get just white. You're gonna need a pencil, and I have some markers here. So you can use markers, crayons, colored pencils, glitter, anything you wanna use to decorate this, stickers. Feel free to bring all your supplies, paint. And what we're gonna start out doing is just writing out the number zero. So many of you may know this already. It's basically just an oval. So I'm gonna do it with my pencil first. And draw an oval onto my page, and that is the number zero. So you can see it here, and I'm gonna go ahead and trace it with blue. And we also have handouts for all our projects, so if you would rather use a handout for this one and trace it instead of drawing your own, you're welcome to do that as well. So I'm just tracing my pencil zero with a marker like this. And again, we just have our oval, and it looks the same either way. So it's just an oval. And so zero basically means that there is nothing. So if there is zero rain, that means it's not raining. And if there are, if there's zero snowflakes, that means there's no snow at all. So zero just means that there is nothing. And it comes before the number one. So before you have one of something, I have one marker. If I don't have this marker, then I have zero markers. And so this hand has one marker, and this hand has zero markers because there's nothing in it. And now we're gonna learn how to spell it out as well. So I'm gonna use this, and I'm just gonna write it at the bottom. So we're gonna go with our Z, because it starts with a zero, starts with a Z. E. R O. So we have four letters for our word zero, and this is going to be backwards because it's in the camera, but we have Z E R O zero, and then our number here. So when you have your letters written out and your number zero written out, you can take another marker and just decorate your page. And zero, the number zero, kind of looks like a smiley face as well. So you can take your marker or color pencil and just draw a smiley face in the middle because it's kind of like a head. So you can remember zero like a smiley face. It's like a oval, and then you put something in it. So what are some other things, other objects you guys see ovals in? When you think about it. So for me, it's a little bit different than a circle. As you can see, it's longer, but it's still kind of that circular thing. So if I think about that, I would think of eggs, or the shape of an oval, or the shape of zero. Planets could be the shape of an oval or zero. You could have clouds, or just different things. Puddles of water could be the shape of an oval. You could have vases that have the opening of a shape of an oval, or eyeglasses with the glass piece having a shape of the oval. So there's all different things you guys could see with the shape of an oval or the number zero. So keep that in mind this week as you guys are looking around, see if you can spot the number zero in things, or the shape of an oval in things, and just point that out and keep that in mind. And if you guys have done your paper or using a handout, you can continue to decorate it, and you can draw around it things that remind you of zero or oval shapes, oval objects. You can draw those on your paper and then just go ahead and decorate your letters. So I just went around and outlined mine in orange with my smiley face and zero. So I hope that made sense for you guys. We are going to continue doing this with all our numbers, and I hope you guys are able to follow along. So thank you again, and I hope you guys have an awesome day.